For he accepted us to be married.
Let
the mother be blessed with the She's elder Anetu Mokasa. And married. And the husband is Mr. Mokasa. Let him rise up and pray to you.
Want
to thank God for this ministry of Kasana Pentecostal Church. And we want to thank the Bishop of this church. All together with other pastors of this
church.
And all together other ministries. Always giving us the opportunity to be
minister
as women. We want to thank God that we have joined together with other mothers in the
world
to see that we celebrate this day of mothers.
But what if we imba anthem yabachara?
As we are singing the anthem of women. You heard that part which was saying that we are the backbone of
families.
We are the backbone.
Yes, we have a
The backbone of person man. Once it is disturbed by anything, you cannot stand. Even sitting. But we thank God for what He made us. I know that He made us that for that reason. Therefore, it is my prayer for every mother who is in this place being the mother to fulfill our role that God created. And we shall also be blessed. Before we start, because once I start, I don't want to go back again to introduce
people.
I want to use this opportunity
to
introduce the committee that will work together in this ministry of
marriage.
If at all it does not hurt you, I request those people to do that. But I will introduce them to the committee. I will work as mothers in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We want to thank God for these women you're seeing coming. When we are given the responsibility of the ministry of
brothers,
we did a duty in us. And we made a committee that takes on the ministry of brothers. And before you, those are some of the people that committee that enables us to bring whatever we bring to you in the name of our Lord. I know all their names. And I'm going to introduce them by their names and their responsibilities. Starting with Mrs. Sekamate, the time is up
on her.
And this committee will allow me to. Next to her is Mrs. Sebaneke. And the committee for this, she's made of gold. Standing next to her, Mrs. Sebaneke is a secretary to this committee. And next to her is the maybe she's known as
this
on the committee for her country. And this comedian, she is called Mrs.
Umoru.
She's in the children's ministry, but also in the family. Next to her is Mrs. Africa. She's a mobilizer. This is the madam who sends you messages and also the information about the mothers. And this has enabled her to learn more Uganda. Next to her is Mrs. Pastor
Maganda.
And she is assistant to her. Next to her is Mrs.
Yotunyimbisi.
She's the head of the music department. If you have seen anything that has gone wrong, just meet her. But because everything has gone wrong,
Betty Wasson.
Is Mrs. Betty Wasson.
Oh, yeah.
She is the head. And what you have seen here,
oh, yeah.
She is the one who hates it and Jesus came back to us. The last one is Miss Jajate. And she is the prayer. I want to thank you, ladies. And I request you to go back to the city. Because he has done this good in this
country.
Sincerely, today is the day of mothers in the whole
country.
And what I know, different areas, mothers are celebrating. And others, what I know, their journey is going to their mothers to appreciate them. But we also thank God because we have the presence of God as we minister to God. We want to thank the fathers, all the gents in a special
way.
Sincerely, if they were not by with us, maybe we would not have
stood.
I just want to also put my hand up. Gentlemen in a special
way,
working around us to prepare ourselves for such a ministry. The minister in the morning was here and we shared the word. And she taught us the responsibilities of a mother and what they have done in this
nation.
Sincere mothers have done a great job in the nation. Even though there are those that have been disturbed and have not performed their roles very well. But we believe that the Holy Spirit is going to help us. That we may fulfill the ministry of
mothers.
We have seen the first service as that cares for a child and nurtures a child. And we have been told that also the husbands help the mothers so that they may fulfill their roles. But this afternoon, because we are the latter days, as we celebrate the day of mothers, as we kukuza, because God made us special mothers, as we thank God because God has given us children, we are not going to forget that we are the latter days. As we are acting the play, it shows that we are the latter days. Whereby people no longer care whether people have been murdered or whatever they are doing. We have seen a father telling the mother as she has brought a lot of money. Yet he was saving off the life. I want to tell you that all the signs of the latter days have been demonstrated. And because of that reason, we are going to share the ways we can live in these latter days. Praise Jesus. We have been in the week of fighting. We have been in the week of attacking our enemy, making him lose whatever he has taken from us. My prayer is that may God give us grace for whatever the devil has stolen from us. We steal it from him. That we may continue. I've come with the same, the same.
Where to live in these last days?
Or on the other way,
examine your heart.
Welcome
and your relationship with God.
God, we want to thank you. For we are going to share your word. We request you, Holy Spirit, what we know that you have already enlightened in this place. Help and teach us. Help and interpret to us. Lord, let me disappear. That you may be my blessing. And whatever we're going to share, to take us on in this journey of salvation. I want God to use a special power to change our lives. And whatever we're going to do, Father, that everyone may take it the way you want it to be taken. As your goodness may continue being manifested in our lives, days of our lives.
Amen.
Amen.
I
want to call you
as
we celebrate this Christmas. I don't want you to forget that we are the last
days.
Mothers, God made us mothers because of our reason. And even fathers, we are made fathers for a reason. And children, we are still children for reasons.
Yes, we
are. Praise Jesus. As we fulfill this reason, we shall inherit eternal life.
Brethren,
in this place, I want to tell you, we God said to go to heaven.
Yes, we are.
Praise Jesus.
We
God said to go to heaven. But in this job of salvation, there are things that we have got, maybe they are miracles.
Or
they may make us excited. And we may
lose it.
But because we are the latter days, we must be prepared.
Yes, we have.
Praise Jesus.
That older one.
Our God
is
coming back anytime. As they were ending the place,
we
are not going to throw this child to because we got saved. That's what they remembered. I'm here to remind you that
you
get the last things. Whereby the born again is supposed to be ready. The Bible says in the book of Matthew, chapter 25, I request somebody to read for us there. Matthew 25, from the first verse. Maybe we may get to the 13th verse. As you get to open for us there, Matthew chapter 25 from verse 1, it speaks about the 10th verse. Praise Jesus.
Ebi egamba nti bobira ebyo obwakabaka obw'omukulu bulifaananyizibwa ng'amabala ekkumi abatwala entabaaza zaabwe ne bagenda okusinkana n'abasomukole
wekomereba mu biro bino obwakabaka
obw'omukulusala
yange olwaleero
tobalikwe
nange mbalirwa ku muwendo
gw'abakabaka
tuyinza tutya okubalirwa ku muwendo gw'abawala abagezigezi
nga
tukumye entabaaza zaffe nga zaaka nga zirimu n'amafuta nga nabala
tugeta
Baalina amagezi ne batwala amafuta mu macupa gaabwe wamu n'ettabaaza zaabwe naye anaawasa omukole bwe yawaayo bonna ne babongoota ne beebaka
wekomerekaawo. In this
journey of salvation, just as I've told you, it's as if Jesus has laid. We
have
waited for him and we have come with. The Bible
said,
when the group laid, these people slumbered. There is slumbering in the church. There is sleeping in the church. But the groom anytime.
Is
we have said, my dear, let's be ready. At any time he comes, he may find us when we are ready. When they say that now it's time for seeking the Lord, have your food jar.
When
they are saying that there is a seminar, so that you may fill your jug. If the groom is to come
at
midnight,
until
find you when you are ready, just you need to add more.
Yes, yes, yes.
Amen.
The Bible says that when he prayed, they slumbered and slept. I don't know what has caused
him
to slumber. It may be all about
this.
That's why you have slumbered and slept. It may be that family. That's why you have slumbered and slept. But the Bible says they are those five girls who are wise, who are having their lamps and oil. I pray today you be among the five wise ones. I pray for you, my dear lady, to be among the five ladies. Even though there is a situation you're facing, that you may be strong in the Lord. Even though there is a situation that you're facing, that you may run to God and not run to any other thing.
What if Christ comes back
and finds you when you're not ready? You're having some deal signing
for
him, but he's just coming, he has just landed. As we are starting, we say, those days, the kingdom of God is to be likened to the 10
girls
that have likened that, that you say, oh, we're here sitting. Let's examine ourselves to see that we are ready. Because our God is coming back
anytime.
But he's coming back to take a charge without his fault. We are supposed to be ready. In everything that we do, let it do it as we glorify our God. Mothers, the responsibility that God has given us, let's do it very well, knowing it that we are supposed to give an account on it. That's what it means.
Naye abalina amagezi ne babaddamu ne babagamba nti wasite gaatumale ffenna nammwe lwakiri mugende eri abatunda mwegulire olw'ekkumi bwe baali bagenda okugula anaawasa omugole n'ajja n'abo abaali beeteeseteese ne bayingira naye mu mbaga ey'obugole oluggi ne luggalwawo.
Imagine that situation.
Okyalina by'obulidde buliddemu.
That we may not be
hurt
when the groom is back and finds us when we are not ready and leaves us. Yet the reason that we are brought to salvation, the reason as to why we got saved, to go to heaven.
Yes,
praise Jesus.
Oluvannyuma abawala bali yakumi n'emu oluvannyuma abawala bali abalala bataano nabo ne bajja ne bagamba nti mukama waffe tukulirewo naye n'addamu n'agamba mazima mbagamba nti sibamanyi kale mutunule kubanga temumanyi lunaku newankubadde ekiseera.
Yesu yeebazibwe.
Amen. Bible tells us to
control.
it means that we are supposed to be ready. Let's be ready in everything that we do. Let's be ready as we minister to our God. Let us be ready in the families as we do things that honor our God. As we hate things that our God does not want. That as the groom comes at any time, whether in the afternoon, whether in the morning, or whether in the night, we may be ready to be taken by him. Why is it that we are always ready? We don't know the moment when he's going to come back. The special thing about it, we are waiting for him to come. In the midst of this journey, there are those who are leaving. You may not know when you are going. It may be the morning or the evening. Brethren, I've requested to
be ready.
If the groom comes, that we may not be left, that we may be among the other five cows who are open for, and after entering the door is closed. Praise Jesus. Let's go to the book of Luke. We shall start from verse 39 to verse 42. Luke 12, 35. Luke
12,
from verse
35.
We are still sharing about being
ready.
You have seen the point. That's
how,
that's what is in the world.
Luka esuleye kuminebili olinyiri olwe olwasi mweta. Mwe sivenga ebimiu mwe watu ya mwe na itabaza za mwe na zaka. Na mwe benjini mwe irenga abantu abali ya mkama wawe. Walidida java umbake yoko kole walidia na kona kuji pamukulile uo amangu wako.
Yes, we have asked some of the people to come.
I request to guard our waste.
Or quest to be immune
to God.
Nachidaba ko, over and over, Chidaba.
I already said,
Munibi.
In the mornings where people
are busy, or Mundu, or Mama,
when somebody has lost a loved one,
or Womani.
Or losing a husband. There is something they tie around a waist like this one. Have you ever questioned yourself why they have to tie around the waist? The reason as to why it's tied around the waist, so that you may stand firm because of the situation it's going through.
Amen.
Most of the times when you're scared or frightened, part of your body, the first part to be hurt is the womb, is the stomach, because of the shape. So they tie around your waist so that you may be strong. I pray to God that you give us for grace. All believers of Christ, let's guide our waist above and stand strong in our Lord and walk as he said until he comes back for us. The Bible has told us to tie around our waist. Once you tie around your waist, you become strong. It is not all about tying this around. But let's walk as the Bible says. When the Bible tells you not to do this, don't do it. Why? Keep yourself ready. When the groom comes, he will just take you straight. Let's continue, Pastor. It's my God, me and you. When he comes back, he finds us. Not this
year-looking.
But in the spiritual world, being worthy to go with him. Let's continue.
Mazimamba gamba anti. Mazimamba gamba galiesiba na tukuza umere najja na baweleza au walija mchisimuko ekyokubiri oba mchokusatu na basanga bwatyo
If there was something
that was alive,
so that you may be counted among the wise girls and in holds eternal life.
Yes, we
have. Praise Jesus.
They
are not
sweet,
but we have
to
be. Because the truth is that we are the last
days.
Let's get the last scripture. Chapter 5. And we start with the first verse. Ephesians 5. Starting from the first verse. And let's get to see what.
So, kali mukoberere nga Katonda ng'abaana abaagalwa. Era mutambulire nga mukwagala. Era nga Kristo bwe yabaagala mmwe. Ne yeewaayo ku lwaffe okubeera ekirabo. Era saddaaka eri Katonda okubeera evvumbe eribunya obulungi. Naye obwenzi n'obugwagwa bwonna n'okwegomba n'okwogerebwanga tebyogerebwangako mu mmwe nga bwe kigwanira abatukuvu. Newankubadde eby'ensonyi, newankubadde ebinyumizibwa eby'obusirusiru, newankubadde okubalaata ebitasaana, naye waakiri okwebazanga.
Ephesians chapter 5, from verse 1 to supposed to be involved as children of God. If the Bible can speak about something which is simple, just
yes,
like flattening.
Yes,
flattening is like joking. Brethren, we are flattered in many ways before the
Lord.
But the Bible has refused
us.
That God just pitied us. And giving his only son and died for us. That love that he showed us. Let it be shown to our friends. Let us walk together as the children of the house of faith without hatred. Without backbiting. So that we may inherit it. We are the latter days. In the presence of the Lord, the
Most Merciful
Sin. Only that we are
Mamonga.
He has said fraternally. Is a fraternally a joke? Then somebody gets to say that I was just joking. You have already seen.
Yes, we have.
Brethren, let's do away with everything that was taken
us to unrighteousness.
Let us have some actions that
we brought.
And let us be ready like the other five girls who are having their lamps and who also having the oil. When the groom arrived like this, for them they just entered and the door was closed. We don't want to be closed
outside.
We still have a chance of changing. Brethren, let's use this chance and do away with unrighteousness and walk as our God wants us to walk. And we shall be blessed. As we are winding up, let's read Matthew 24. Matthew 24:42.
kale mutunule kubanga temumanyi lunaku bweruli mukama waffe lwalijirako naye kino mutegeere nti alina enjuye singa yamanya olwanamu ebbiri Matayo esula ya 24 olunyiriri olwanamu ebbiri kugambe bweruti kale mutunule kubanga temumanyi lunaku bweruli mukama waffe mukama wammwe lwalijirako
mukama
akuwomukisa. May God bless you.
Abooluganda,
let's be watchful.
Tubeere beetegefu.
And be ready.
Nga bwe tutamanyi
kaseera newankubadde. Just as we don't know the moment, let it be a minute.
Tubeere katwekumbira mu butuufu.
Let's keep ourselves in righteousness. Let us be ready. Let us please ourselves. Just as we have a chance of pleasing ourselves. When the groom comes, we shall be counted among the wise ones. I ask God to give us grace that we may not be we still stand a chance of repenting. But when we repent for our
unrighteousness,
let's request for another grace that we may be established in our God so that we may not go back to the sinful nature we have
been.
Praise Jesus.
What
has happened? We come before the presence of the Lord as we repent. And we don't request for grace to be established that we may not go back to where we are. This afternoon, I want to lead you in prayer as we stand in the presence of the Lord. And we tell Him, God pity us for all our wrongdoings. I request it
today.
And also request for new grace that we may be established after being forgiven. And walk as He wants us to go. That we may inherit eternal life.
God the
Father,
we thank
you.
This
is here we was talking to
our God. God, we want to
dislike
a blood-based
congregation. We want to live to our sinful nature that we have
walked through.
All the things that you have done that have been abominable. But because of this afternoon, we have
not
been able
to dislike a
blood-based congregation.
Tu savais que c'était un diable, comme on tout Come on, I want you to stand.
God bless you.